Now to the story we've been talking about all weekend. How much food do you throw out every day? Well, it turns out we Aussies are a nation of wasters, throwing out over 4 million tonnes of food that just ends up in landfill. It's enough to fill 8,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools. That is awful. Now, we spoke to one family recently who were combating this waste crisis, one bin at a time. Mandy and her son Ethan take to the trash to find perfectly good food that is simply chucked out by supermarkets. Now, it's a practice that divided our Facebook page. Some people said that they find it absolutely disgusting. So, we sent our reporter, David Robertson, along to check it out and see exactly what dumpster diving involves.
How much of the food in your fridge has come from a dumpster?
Yeah, about 80 to 90% of wow. what we actually eat.
Okay. So how much does that save you per week in groceries?
We roughly think about $150 to $200 a week.
Wow, that's amazing.
Mandy is just one member of a fast-growing group who dumpster dives. It's getting so big that they even have Facebook pages dedicated to their cause.
What made you go, OK, I'm going to give this a go and I'm going to eat the food that I get out of a bin?
I wanted to become a lot more simplistic and not rely so much on money.
Her table alone is covered with products that were trashed to the supermarkets, but treasure to Mandy.
Is there a bin diving etiquette? Like, if you go there and someone's already going for it, do you leave them? Like, how does that work? Is there a rule?
So if somebody else is already there, or if somebody else rocks up while you're there, I think everybody's more than welcome to sort of join in.
If people have a go at you and say, oh, it's gross, it's disgusting, what do you say to them?
I'd probably say it's actually not gross and disgusting, and there is actually a lot of waste out there. And have a look at some of the stuff that I get. And I have had people that have been like, yeah, no, I'm not going to do it. And then they've seen me bring in a bag of pears and they've gone, did you get that out of the dumpster? And I went, yeah, do you want some? And they're like, OK, yeah, sure.
Ethan, do you ever worry about going dumpster diving and what people will think?
No, not really.
Why is that?
Well, if friends really, like, criticise me, then I just leave it and just try and, like, walk away and stuff.
When you first ate something that you got out of a bin, were you just, OK, I'm just going to dive in, do it quickly, rip the Band-Aid off and see how I go? Is that how it was when you first did it?
I don't know. The very first stuff was chicken we got. I guess I was probably...
You went the chicken straight up?
I know.
That's a dangerous territory there that you're moving into.
Yeah, it was still cold, but I don't know that you can really just rip the Band-Aid off and just...
Just take the chicken?
Just eat it.
But it's not just the money saving that makes Mandy search through a bin. It also comes down to a problem she has with just how much we waste. Globally, over $1 trillion of food goes straight into the rubbish. That means over one third of food produced never makes it to the plate. And Australia is a big part of the problem. Each year, this wide brown land throws out almost $9 billion worth of food. And Mandy's on a mission to reduce that astronomical number. And we went along for the ride.
Do you get excited going dumpster diving, Ethan?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's really cool.
So, Mandy, how often would you do this a week?
Just once a week, generally.
Yeah. And it's always at night, isn't it?
Yes, it's always at night, once the stores are closed.
Would there be anything that would make you stop dumpster diving?
Jail?
Yeah.
That's where, well, it kind of gets tricky. Dumpster diving is generally not illegal, but only if the goods have been genuinely abandoned and you're not trespassing to get those goods. But it's very important to remember that the rules and laws change from council to council and state to state.
So what we're looking for here is that it's all dark. That's
yes.
what you're looking for?
Yes.
Okay.
And there's no cars in the car park, so...
No cars, so we...
Yeah, just
come in here.
Drop it there. So if I come up here and I find there's cars in the car park, I'll do a quick count.
Yep.
And I'll drive out the back way and I'll sit opposite the road and wait till I've counted that many cars have come out.
Right, okay. Hey. Do you get excited when you do it?
Yeah, like if you say you can't go, you can't look in there, I'm like, let's look.
Yeah.
Like, what's going to be in there?
Yeah, right.
As soon as the dumpster door opens, the hunt begins.
So it still has a bin smell, though, doesn't it? So does that ever put you off?
To me, it's when I used to work in retail, it's kind of like what the back smells like with all the cardboard boxes.
Sure, sure, sure.
and stuff.
Yep.
So, no, not really. It doesn't put me off. Hamburger, that is.
This kind of looks like it's been damaged a little bit. Would you still take that?
I would. I will.
Yeah? Because that looks like it's not properly...
Well, it isn't sealed there, but it'll be OK.
So even if it's not sealed, you'll look at that and go, that's all right?
Yeah, but don't tell my husband.
I'm sure he won't find out.
There's lots of good stuff tonight, actually.
Yeah?
Look, there's tomatoes, chicken. There's heaps of bread here, just oodles of it. See, that one's split, so I wouldn't take that home.
You're doing the cold test, so you...
Yeah.
The test that you go through is the temperature, what it feels like, what it looks like, what it smells like.
Yes, and it's also not bloated.
When is this out of date, for example?
I think a couple of days ago.
OK. So would you eat this now?
Yes.
This is a couple of days old?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Is there one thing you wouldn't take out of a dumpster that you'll only ever buy it from a store?
Probably if you got to the nitty-gritty of it, and I haven't ever found any, would probably be the sanitary items. Oh, see, look, caster sugar. My auntie would use that.
It was at this point that the operation was momentarily shut down. Out of nowhere, a single car drives through the deserted car park.
You got a little bit worried there, so did I, actually. Do you ever get worried?
I mainly get worried about being charged because I don't know what the fine is and I probably can't afford it. Realistically.
You might want to start to pack up because they've left, so they might come around a second time.
Ethan, do you like doing this?
Yeah, it's kind of addictive.
We've got pancakes.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Muffins, crumpets. Mm.
Well, I know what I'll be having for breakfast tomorrow morning.
Is this a good night?
This is very small in comparison to what we normally get, but there's some good variety here.
Oh, after a big night, it's time to taste the fruits of our labour, isn't that right? What are we going to eat, Mandy?
We're going to have toasted ham, cheese and a tomato sandwich.
Yep, and all of this has actually come from where we found it tonight.
Yes, that's right.
Let's get cooking.
Yeah, it's all good.
So have you ever been sick by eating anything?
No, we've never been sick.
Never?
Never. Never.
Because this is my first time eating dumpster diver food. Should I be excited?
Yeah, you'll survive.
So let's dig in. We've had a big night. Lovely. Cheers, everyone.
Cheers.
Thanks for having us. Beautiful.
Robbo's on the desk with us. That was a cracking story. You looked unsure tasting that toast.
I was very unsure because there's meat in it. Meat's the one, the thing that worries me a lot.
Yeah.
But
chicken terrifies me.
But Mandy said that she's never been sick. The family's never been sick. She tested on the family first, but they've never been sick.
How was the smell?
It smells like a bin. So it smells like what?
Bin.
Yeah, I was about to say that, you know, you've been at home, but I think my bin is the only one that smells like that. But it's like a bad kind of smell.
Right. So it's... And does it still hang around you when you get back?
I pretty much washed the skin off my hands when I got back to the
Yeah, well, I would have thought gloves might have been...
Yeah, I was going to say...
Oh, no, I didn't touch anything. It was just because I was near it, yes.
I've got to say, though, the amount of food that we waste is just embarrassing. Mm. And although I think sometimes she's probably... It's a line ball, like if there was meat in there that in a broken package that was a few days out of date. But the other stuff...
The bacteria that builds up in a bin, especially if it's warm, doing this in summer would be horrific because, you know, that said, I've been a person that always thought the use-by date was a bit flexible.
Yeah, for sure. A gentle suggestion.
Yeah, for sure.
Guidelines.
But there was a lot of things like tomatoes that were in bags.
Yeah.
I thought that was actually fine.
Things are bagged and sealed.
Yeah, and bread seemed to be okay. Yeah. I couldn't go meat.
And
but
tins that were just a bit dented.
Tins were fine, things like that. But a shop actually gets in trouble. This is a weird kind of thing. They've got to write off so much food that they've got. Otherwise, it is bad for the bottom line. Now, it goes like this. If you've got hot food, like a sandwiches or meat pies and things like that, if you sell out of them, then that to the company is kind of a loss because if a customer came in and said, I wanted a meat pie, you don't have one here, I won't come back here. So they kind of
put that in, oversupply
in order for that to work, which is what the massive problem here is. And Mandy finds all sorts of things like soap, detergent. She found a slow cooker. Yep.
What, was anything wrong with it?
No.
Packaging damaged or something?
Well, there was no packaging. She just took that.
Oh, okay. Right.
Is there a school of thought, like as long as it's not going into landfill and hurting the environment or whatever, is there a school of thought that actually oversupply is good for the economy? I mean, is it not... It's better for the growers, it's better for the producers. If the supermarkets are paying for all this extra stuff, I mean, as long as, you know, you're not ripping it off the table of some small child starving in Africa.
No. One of the biggest problems that Mandy has in her family is that
the cow was slaughtered for no reason.
Right.
So that's a big thing, and that's what they don't like. Also, the food... She's saying that there should be no one going hungry in Australia when you're wasting $9 billion worth of food.
Well,
like,
food,
what is going
food
on?
Food bank do great work.
Yes, too. Which they do. Yes, which we saw that with the strawberries. But it's a massive problem, and she's finding slowly that more and more bins are being locked.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
But locked because they're still throwing out the same amount.
Oh, yes.
It's just that they don't want...
They don't want the people going through it. So once it's locked, it's now trespassing and it is illegal.
I wonder if that's a health issue. Robbo, that was a really good story.
Thank you
so much.